Hello everybody and welcome to another War Thunder upcoming content video. This is the third dev blog that they released today. Most likely released earlier today at some point, I don't know. As you'll know if you watched my previous two dev blog videos, I was up way too late, past 6 in the morning, and finally when I got the chance to lay down and go to sleep, wake up and there's another dev blog there. So I don't know when exactly this one released, sometime today between the 7 a.m. to the 1 p.m. mark. But it is of Italy's new upcoming main Beetle tank, which is the OF-40 Mark IIA, which is actually one of two of the OF main battle tanks that you get at the top tier for their Ground Forces tech tree. I think that this is the second variant, I hope. Otherwise I'm going to sound like an idiot more so than I already do. So the OF-40 was the first tank designed and produced in Italy after the end of World War II, whose design was heavily influenced by the German Leopard 1. Boy, I would never have guessed. I thought this looked like a Russian T-26. Coming to War Thunder as part of the upcoming 1.85 update, the OF-40 Mark II will be one of the vehicles waiting for players at the top rank of the highly anticipated Italian Ground Forces tree. So because this thing resembles the Leopard 1 quite a bit, I think it looks gorgeous, and that's just because I think the Leopard 1 looks gorgeous, so, and the Leopard 2, early variants at least. Briefly, it is a late 1970s MBT, closely resembling the German Leopard 1 in terms of performance and design. There's some history on the unit, and here we can take a look at one of their paint schemes they got going on here. Presumably one of their high-tier paint schemes. Mounted 50 caliber machine gun. Smoke dispensers, looks like all of your usual stuff. You can look at its butt. Pretty square. I like square. Square's good. In War Thunder, the OF-40 Mark II will be one of the vehicles available to tankers at rank 6 of the Italian Ground Forces tree, coming to the game with the upcoming update 1.85. Due to the close resemblance to its German cousin, players who have already used the Leopard 1 will likely recognize a lot of features both vehicles have in common. When it comes to mobility, the OF-40 Mark II and Leopard 1 share the exact same characteristics, an 830-horsepower diesel engine capable of pushing both vehicles up to a maximum top speed of 65 kilometers an hour. However, due to the slightly higher weight of the OF-40 Mark II, tankers might experience a small negative effect on the vehicle's acceleration and braking action. The armor protection on both vehicles might also appear to be pretty similar at first, but upon closer inspection, some differences will become apparent. Apart from the similar hull armor layout, the armor thickness going up to 70 millimeters, the OF-40 Mark II is slightly better protected than the Leopard, thanks to a better turret protection. That's great. And you know how the Leopard doesn't have much armor on it to begin with, the Leopard 1, I mean. Yet sometimes you shoot at it and it just bounces off, and that is a really oh shit brown pants moment. Now we got a top-down view of the vehicle. Gross. Another shot with that tricolor paint. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, okay. I just had to make sure it was tri. And another shot of the turret. Pretty simplistic design, I have to say. Very, very straight. A lot of edges. Not a lot of curvature. But that's what I like in a tank, personally. The OF-40 Mark II features a spaced armor profile all around the vehicle's turret. Compared to the Leopard 1, such an armor configuration provides the OF-40 Mark II with slightly better turret protection and offers increased effectiveness against both kinetic and chemical rounds. The OF-40 Mark II is also equipped with the familiar 105mm L7 cannon used on numerous NATO vehicles of the time. Specifically, on the later Mark II model, this cannon received a two-plane stabilization system, something that wasn't the case with initial production models. As such, commanders of the OF-40 Mark II can expect to choose from the usual assortment of very potent subcaliber and chemical munitions found on many high-ranking vehicles of the Western nations. In addition to this, the OF-40 Mark II is also equipped with a single 7.62mm MG mounted quartzly, as well as a 50-caliber heavy machine gun on the turret. The OF-40 Mark II will become available to all players as part of the top rank of the Italian Ground Forces tech tree, coming to War Thunder with the release of Update 1.85. Until then, stay tuned to the news to find out more about the next major update coming to the game very soon. See you on the battlefield. So, they didn't really talk about much in the way of both vehicles, so I'm assuming they just wanted to show off one variant right now, the variant that matters, I guess. There's still lots of stuff that they could do dev blogs on, but it looks like they're trying to get some of the meaty stuff out. Like they're getting, we still have the Javelin, so they just did the MiG-19. Now they did the MBT for the Italian ground forces, et cetera. They did the Type 89, et cetera, et cetera. So it looks like now they're wanting to rush out the beefy stuff with the map and things, with the update coming right around the corner. I don't know when it's releasing, but it will definitely be before Christmas. I would guess sometime within the next week, and a half, give or take. But well, let me know in the comments below if you're excited for this new Italian ground forces main Beetle tank, or if you're more excited for something else. But until the next video, guys, I will see you then. Or what? Well, that didn't make any sense. Apparently, I'm still tired.